Hi, this is Ajay Anand and welcome to science classes from excelup.com. In this lesson, you will learn about force and pressure. This chapter is from class 8 science. You will learn about definition of force, then you will learn about various effects of force, then types of force, and at the end of the lesson, you will learn about pressure. What is force? A push or a pull is called force. So when you are pushing something, you are applying force on that object. Similarly, when you are pulling something, you are applying force on that object. This guy is trying to push a rock, so he is applying force on the rock. This little boy is pulling a toy cart, so this boy is applying force on the toy cart. There are some salient features about force. One of them is that at least two objects, they are required to interact in order to apply force. So one of them will be applying force and another will experience the effects of force. Force is a scalar quantity, which means that a force has magnitude as well as direction. So let us say in this case, when we say that this boy is applying force, this will be an incomplete statement. But when we say that this boy is applying force in a particular direction, say from left to right, then it is a complete statement, that which is giving the magnitude of force as well as direction of force. In real life, more than one force is, they are always acting on an object. Okay. So just to simplify the matter, let us assume that two forces are acting on an object. So what will happen in that case? If both the forces, they are acting in the same direction, then the net effect will be sum of the forces, okay? And if the forces, they act opposite to each other, then the net effect will be equal to the difference between forces. So you can understand this by taking the example of the game of tug of war. In this game, there are two teams and they pull a rope. Both the teams, they apply force in direction opposite to each other. So the team on the left hand side, it applies force towards left, and the team on the right hand side applies force towards the right. So as long as the force in both the directions is same, the net effect will be zero and the rope will not move even an inch. The moment either of the team applies a force greater than the force applied by another team, what happens? The rope will move in the direction of greater force. So say, for example, this team, it applies more force compared to this team. So the rope will move in this direction and this team, it will become the winner of the game. Effect of force. Force has effect on state of motion as well as on shape. So if an object is at rest, it can move after application of force, and if an object is moving, it can come to rest after application of force. Okay, so let us say this huge bear is at rest, he's enjoying rest. Now this guy is applying force in order to move this bear. If this guy applies enough force, then he may be able to move the bear from rest. Then these examples, they show the effect of force on a moving object or on an object in motion. So what will happen? Let us say there is a car and the driver pushes the accelerator pedal. So once the accelerator is increased, force is applied in the direction of motion. So what will happen? This will increase the rate of motion, that is speed. So speed of the car will increase. On the other hand, if the driver applies brake on the car, then the force is applied in direction opposite to motion. So in that case, the rate of motion will decrease. And if brake is applied for sufficient time and in sufficient amount, a time may come when the car will come to stop. So it will come into the state of rest. Force can also change the direction of motion. This figure shows a batsman playing a hook shot. So the ball is coming from in front of him. So this is coming straight from in front of him once the bowler throws the ball. So what happens? This batsman, he hits the ball. So once the ball is hit, the direction of motion of the ball will change. The ball will go to, say, let us say, to the boundary or square boundary or wherever the batsman aims it to be. Okay, so this example shows that how force can change direction of motion. The same thing can be observed in the game of football when a player kicks the ball, or in the game of hockey, even game of carom board, you can see how force can change the direction of motion. Force can change the effect of shape also. So this example, it shows a potter. He is trying to give shape to the lump of clay. So by applying force, he can change the lump of clay into beautiful pottery. This figure is a balloon made of different animals. So this is a cute dog made up of balloons. So what the balloon seller does, he twists and turns various balloons into different shape to make replicas of monkey, dog, birds and many other animals. When someone in the kitchen applies force on the lump of dough, the shape of dough changes into bread. So this is another example of how application of force can change the shape of an object. Types of force. There are two types of force. One is called contact force and another is called non-contact force. A force which needs direct or indirect contact to be made with the object in order to be applied is called contact force. But when you don't need to make contact in to apply a particular force, then the force is called a non-contact force. Muscular force and friction, they are examples of contact force. For applying both the forces, we need to make the contact. So for example, let us say here is a donkey and it is trying to pull a cart. So in order to apply its muscular force, the donkey will need to make contact with the cart. It will be through a harness or a rope, then only the donkey will be able to pull the cart. Friction is a force which comes into play when one surface is motion in relation to another surface. So when one surface is moving over another surface, a force comes into action which opposes the motion, and this force is called friction. So when the wheels of a car are moving on the road, the force of friction will be there between the wheel and the road. And the force of friction will always be in the opposite direction of motion, and the force of friction will always oppose motion. You will read about detail in friction in detail about friction in the next chapter. Non-contact force, the examples are magnetic force, electrostatic force and gravitational force. So you may have observed that when you bring a magnet near nails or all pins, the nails and all pins, they are attracted towards magnet even from a distance. You don't need to, you know, touch the nails with your magnet. This is a quite familiar figure. This is a comb, and small bits of paper, they are sticking to the comb. So when you move comb in dry hair for some time, the comb gets charged because of static electricity, and the force because of static electricity is called electrostatic force. So if you will rub a plastic refill or a ruler or pen with a cloth, all of them, they become charged with static electricity, and this charge creates the electrostatic force. So a charged body can attract another charged or uncharged body because of electrostatic force, and this force, it can be applied without making the contact. Gravitational force is the force of attraction in all the objects in the universe. So when something is thrown up in the air, it falls down on the earth because of gravitational force of the earth. Okay, so this is all about contact forces and non-contact forces. Pressure. The force per unit area is called pressure. So pressure is equal to force upon area. In this equation, force is in numerator, which means pressure is directly proportional to force, which means pressure will increase with increase in force. Area is in denominator, which means pressure is inversely proportional to the area on which force is acting. So if area is increased, pressure will decrease. Okay, let us observe these examples to understand the effect of area and force on pressure. So in this case, here are two nails. This nail is kept on its blunt end, and this nail is standing on its pointed end on a wooden block. So it is clear that when you will try to, you know, push the nail with hammer, it will be difficult to push this nail rather than this one, because the area of the tip is less than the area of the head of the nail, and because of lower area, more pressure will be created for the same amount of force. The soldier straps of your school bags, they are wide, so that the wider area will create lower pressure on your soldiers, and it will be quite comfortable to carry the school bags. Had there been a narrow strip, it would have been quite difficult or painful, you know, to carry the school bag. Camels, they have wide feet, padded feet, and because of which they are able to walk on sand comfortably, because the wider feet means more area, and more area means less pressure on the sand. So these are the real life implications of pressure. Pressure by fluid. Anything which has mass can, you know, exert pressure. So fluid also have mass. Air or water, they are examples of fluid. So here are some illustrations of showing properties of pressure by fluid. So what happens? Pressure at the bottom of container depends on the height of fluid. So here are two jars, and they are hollow jars from both the ends. Balloons have been tied at the bottom of these jars. Okay, so this jar contains a less amount of water compared to this jar. So the height of the column of water in this jar is lower than the height of the column of water in this jar, and because of this, this balloon is inflated to a lesser extent compared to this balloon. This happens because of greater pressure in this jar because of more height of water column present. Okay, then another property is that pressure is exerted on wall of the container. For this, you can conduct an experiment. Take an empty plastic bottle, make a small hole on the wall of the plastic bottle, and insert a tube in this hole. Now tie a balloon on this tube. So once you will fill water in this bottle, what will happen? The balloon will inflate because a pressure being created by water. So this shows that pressure is exerted on walls of the container. Now you can conduct more experiments. So let us now take this plastic bottle and make some hole on the walls of the bottle, and all the holes, they should be at the same height. So you will see, once water is filled in the bottle, the water nozzles coming out of all the holes, they will reach the same distance because the pressure is equal at equal depth, and that is why all the water jets, they will reach the same distance. You can alter this experiment by, you know, changing the levels of holes. So let us say make one hole over here, make another hole higher up or even higher up, and now fill water in this bottle. So now you will observe that water jet from the lowest hole, it reaches the farthest compared to water jet at the topmost hole. So this jet will reach over here covering a shorter distance, and this jet will reach over here covering a longer distance. So this shows that pressure increases with depth, and that is why when divers, they enter the sea and they reach the depth of the ocean, they experience even greater pressure, and to withstand that pressure, the huge pressure inside ocean, the divers, they have to wear special diving suits so that their body can cope up with the pressure. So I talked about the definition of force. Then I talked about effect of force on motion and effect of force on shape of an object. After that, I talked about types of forces, that is contact forces and non-contact forces. Then I talked about the pressure and how does pressure behave with increase or decrease in area on which the force acts. And at the end of the lesson, I talked about pressure exerted by fluids. That's all for this lesson. Thank you.